or to try conclusions with such an antagonist in a wrestling bout. Consider the day's round of his existence. The sides are being picked up in a football match, but he is left out as the odd man. There is no place for him. During the choric dance, he is driven away into ignominious quarters. Nay, in the very streets it is he who must step aside for others to pass, or, being seated, he must rise and make room, even for a younger man. At home, he will have his maiden relatives to support in isolation, and they will hold him to blame for their unwedded lives. A hearth with no wife to bless it, that is a condition he must face. And yet he will have to pay damages to the last farthing for incurring it. Let him not roam abroad with a smooth and smiling countenance. Let him not imitate men whose fame is irreproachable, or he shall feel on his back the blows of his superiors. Such being the weight of infamy which is laid upon all cowards, I, for my part, am not surprised if, in Sparta, they deem death preferable to a life so steeped in dishonor and reproach. Part 10. That, too, was a happy enactment, in my opinion, by which Lycurgus provided for the continual cultivation of virtue even to old age. By fixing the election to the Council of Elders as a last ordeal at the goal of life, he made it impossible for a high standard of virtuous living to be disregarded even in old age. So, too, it is worthy of admiration in him that he lent his helping hand to virtuous old age.